and welcome to our topic lesson. We're going to start by saying our key vocabulary. Wow, this is a long word. It's got six syllables, so we need to do six claps when we say it. Paleontologist, your turn. My turn. Extinct, your turn. Yes, and extinct means that they're not around anymore. They don't live anymore. My turn. Fossil, your turn. Yes, and that's what paleontologists are looking for when they are hunting for things. They are hunting for fossils. We're just going to recap our timeline that we've been looking at last week. Dinosaurs lived a very long time ago, so they're way back here on our timeline. Mary Anning, who was a fossil hunter, who was a paleontologist, was born 200 years ago, so she was around here on our timeline. Me and Miss West, we were born around here. And then you were born only about 4 or 5 years ago. You were born after Miss West, so you come at the end of our timeline. Okay, so what we need to remember is that dinosaurs lived a long, long, long time ago, way before we were born, okay? So today we're going to be paleontologists. We're going to look and to see how the dinosaurs are the same and how some dinosaurs are different. That's what we're going to be thinking about today. So, have a look at this dinosaur. I wonder if you remember what this dinosaur's name was. Yes, it was the T-Rex. Can you pause the video and can you tell an adult? Can you describe the T-Rex to an adult? Pause the video. What does it look like? What might it eat? Tell an adult. Yes, a T-Rex has really short arms. But can you remember? Its arms are very strong. Even though they're short and small, they're so strong. Because it's a meat eater, it needed to have really short, strong arms to catch its prey. It's a carnivore. It eats meat. Because it eats meat, it needed to have very sharp teeth. And it looks like it's got bumpy skin. That's the T-Rex. Now I would like you to describe the Stegosaurus to an adult. What does it look like? What might it eat? Tell an adult. So the Stegosaurus had looks like spikes going across its back. It had a teeny tiny little head, and remember, it didn't actually have any teeth. It looks like it's got a bumpy skin as well, and it's got a little tail. Okay, so that is the Stegosaurus. And finally, I wonder if you can remember what this dinosaur was called. Yes, it was called the Diplodocus. Can you say that? Yes, pause the video. Describe the Diplodocus to an adult. Well done. The Diplodocus also had short arms and it had longer back legs. It had a long tail. I wonder if you can remember why the Diplodocus might have had a long tail. Yes, it was to fight off predators. Okay, and the Diplodocus has a very long neck, much longer than the Stegosaurus's neck. I wonder if you can remember why. Why did it have a really long neck? Yes, it was to eat leaves from trees. It was so it could reach the trees. It ate plants. So that is the Diplodocus. Now what I would like you to do, we've got the picture of the T-Rex. We've got the picture of the Stegosaurus and we've got the picture of the Diplodocus. I would like you to think about how they are the same. How do they look the same? What have they got that's the same? And how are they different? Okay, so have a look. How are they the same and how are they different? Do you know, just before you answer that, paleontologists don't know a lot about the dinosaur skin. Fossils suggested that dinosaur skin is bumpy, and only on a plant eater was it scaly. Okay, so they didn't actually know much about the skin of dinosaurs, but fossils did suggest that dinosaur skin was bumpy, and when it was a plant-eater dinosaur, it had scaly skin. Okay, so pause the video, tell an adult, how are the dinosaurs the same? How do they look the same? Maybe they eat the same things. And how are they different? Pause the video. Well done. I can see that the Diplodocus and the T-Rex both have shorter arms at the front. They've got shorter arms at the front. I can also see that the T-Rex and the Diplodocus and the Stegosaurus all have quite bumpy skin. They've got scaly skin. Okay, bumpy skin. It's not smooth. So that's another way that it's the same. And finally, they all have eyes. I can see that the T-Rex has eyes. I can see that the Stegosaurus has eyes. And I can see that the Diplodocus all have eyes. That's another way that they are the same. Some ways that they are different is that the Diplodocus has a very long neck, but the Stegosaurus and the T-Rex do not have a very long neck, do they? I can see that the T-Rex has really sharp teeth, but I don't think that the Diplodocus or the Stegosaurus have really sharp teeth. So that's a way that they are different to each other. Okay, so we've been looking at how they are the same and how they are different. Well done if you thought of other ways they're the same or other ways they are different. Good job. Have a look at some of the dinosaur's skin. That's some of the dinosaur's skin. This one has little circles on its skin, and this one looks a little bit like a crocodile's skin. Okay, but this one has more crisscrossed skin. And finally, this one looks like it's got some lines for its skin. So they're all a little bit different. The scaly skin, the bumpy skin. Okay. And we're going to finish by reading our sentence. And our sentence has our I trigraph in one of the words, so we must remember that. Right, let's get our pointy finger and point to Miss Butler and point to the floor and point to the skin. Let's go back. The skin might. Let's go back. The skin might be bumpy. It might be bumpy. We're not 100% sure, remember, because the paleontologists find the fossils and it suggests that they might be bumpy. Okay, so the skin might be bumpy. Children, in your workbook, you can go to the work pack named Monday and you can complete the activity about dinosaurs in your workbook. It should be named. Have a lovely day. See you tomorrow.